Okay, I'm listening to KGRA Digital Broadcasting, January 12th, 2016, Georgia. I don't know, and it says Larry Cates, CATES, and this is the one where it was a sighting. The investigator was Larry Cates, and the sighting was by a man named Joshua, I think. And I got to the top of the hour, and then I had to quit for a while. So I'm going to do the second hour, which is the main case. He and his friend are driving home from work outside Atlanta, and they saw what they thought was an airplane above them, but it was so low they thought it was going to crash land in the highway and they were going to hit it. But then as they proceeded, it didn't move. And then as they got closer to, I guess, maybe the tip of the triangle or something, because I know this is a triangular craft. There were no flashing lights, they said, which was very weird for an airplane. So he realizes it's flying very low, but it's not moving. He says it's not moving. They were northbound and they knew it wasn't a helicopter. They thought it might because it was stationary, but they didn't see any propellers. The evil ones don't want me listening to MUFON, giving me a wicked headache. I'm gonna change headsets, see if it helps. God, please help me. Don't let them give me a headache while I listen to this. Firm, reaffirm. Firm, reaffirm. Firm, reaffirm. The power of an infinite number of infinities. He said it was metallic, but that it was darker than the sky. That it was darker than the sky. He said it wasn't shiny, it was dull. Much darker than the sky. He said the sky in that close to Atlanta is never really dark because of all the lights, the street lights and the turnpike lights or the interstate lights or whatever. He said he saw the back. He was northbound. He was northbound. It was stationary. The apex of the triangle was pointed. I thought he said northbound, but he was driving under a fixed triangular vehicle and saw the back. He said there was a red light, and then in the perimeter that he could see of the triangle, they were all white lights. Four white lights per side, and then the red in the back. He said he couldn't pull over because there's nowhere to pull over. They passed the back of the object, and then they found a place where they could get off and circle around and try to come back to see it from the other direction, but it was gone. It was at about 2 in the morning, so there wasn't much traffic. He said at about 6 in the morning he was online after when he got home. He said there was a similar craft reported in New Hampshire. He said about 6 in the morning, a similar craft was reported in New Hampshire, quite a while away. They've really messed me up here, the evil ones. There may be something about this case noteworthy. Because Satanists don't want me listening to it. They were saying in the first 12 days of whatever year I'm in, of, I don't know if it's 2016 or 2017, that the sighting was, or the broadcast, but they had tech reports of triangular craft in the first 11 or 12 days of the year. Please help me. A computer graphics company took the witness reports and made a computer graphic of what had been reported. I think they're talking about Illinois. And then the guy lost his job. They're saying the stigma attached to this subject has been fixed for years and years. And Larry Cates says he doesn't expect that to change for a long time. Oh. They're stinging the underside of my leg. He said, Josh says he doesn't think there's any sound attached. He was driving in mild traffic at 55 miles an hour, and he didn't roll his window down, but he said something tells him there was going to be no sound from it. Phoenix Lights case, it was a wedge shaped object. There were hundreds, if not thousands, of witnesses. And he said it was just huge, that a 747 could have easily landed on one of the wings of it. And that it was completely silent. They're taking a break. I'm gonna pause this and pick it up when I get back. I have to go to the other room. At one point, Josh said it seemed to be hovering purposefully by a radio tower. And also, he mentioned Old Beaver Road or something. The reason I'm so interested in the Georgia case is because Mary Landsberg was hospitalized in Georgia. She and her family, her husband Joe and the kids, lived in Tampa, Florida. But she said there was something wrong with her foot, and they took her to a hospital in Georgia, where she spent more than a year. And my interpretation was she was getting a mind control tune-up and oil change. And Joe Roberts, who is apparently an important figure in Satanism, is from Georgia. He's either from or lived in Warner Robins, Georgia, I think. And he has a daughter named Michelle from a previous marriage. I'm not sure where she lived. I do think I remember him mentioning Warner Robins, but I'm not 100%. So, yeah, I'm gonna listen to their break, and then I'll catch up with you. Satanists are making it very hard for me to listen. They were traveling in the northbound lane, and the object itself was hovering in the southbound lane. The driver saw it outside his window, but the passenger couldn't. So we're the object. He says Gwinnett County, Gwinnett. Police Department and Emergency Services use that section of airspace for an emergency corridor. It's a corridor for the air traffic. They were one lane from the center wall that divides the north and southbound lanes. Said there were lights on either side of the walls, northbound, southbound. Lights, you know, like street lights. He said the street lights or the interstate lights were not reflecting from the craft. The street lights are pointed down, there's a hood over them. There's like this big violent reaction to this tape, to this program. He said the hair on the back of his neck stood up when he realized what he was seeing, and he was shaking almost all the way home. So there's Larry Kate said there is a military base to the north of where the sighting was. But he doesn't know the name, he doesn't remember the name of it. They said the following week is Clarkson, James Clarkson, who was actually, I think they said their first interview for that year, but that he had come down with a really bad cold and could barely speak without choking and coughing. So I'll look for Larry Clarkson. This is the last one that this one that I'm doing, that I'm finishing. It's the last one I think that I'll give notes to. You know, I want to be fair to MUFON. It's $6.99 a month to belong to KGRA digitalbroadcasting.com. KGRADB.com. And if your interest is piqued, it's not too expensive. So okay, I was in 2016. Aired on January 12th, 2016. And or the sighting date was January 12th? I don't know. Because the James Clarkson is dated as January 12th. So I'm not sure what that is, but that's probably going to be the one I listen to next. But I'm not going to do any more notes. I think KDRA, KGRADB.com is interesting enough without me taking notes on them. Okay, I'll upload those to Facebook and Twitter and stuff.